relays can be a little bit daunting, but they really have a good application in the ATV space. If you're adding accessories to your ATV, like light bars, hand warmers, spotlights, seat warmers, any other kind of accessories you want to add, and you keep tying things to your ignition source, when you turn on one of those things, you're going to blow the fuse and then you're going to be dead up in the mountain somewhere because your fuse blew on your ignition. What I have here is I have an ATV battery that's holding 12 volts. I got a couple of alligator clips that tie over to a relay, and I have a light bar that I'm about to install on my Rubicon before this weekend. So on the Rubicon, on the left-hand side, there's a little switch that you can turn the high beams on. What I want to do is I want to tie this relay to the high beam switch to power this light bar. So when I kick it on, it'll power the relay and the light bar straight from the battery instead of through my lighting circuit. What I've got here is a relay. And if you notice on a relay, there are four tabs on it and they have a bunch of silly numbers next to them that don't make any sense. I'm going to make sense of them for you. So on these relays for vehicles, they're usually a 30 or 40 amp relay. The 30 is always the power that goes directly from your battery. So you want to take your positive battery and hook it to the 30 terminal. That feeds full power to the relay. The next numbers are 85, 86, and 87. Each one of those wires have a purpose. So I'm going to try to explain an easy way of how to remember which is which. So 85 is the ground. So if you think back to the 1985 movie, Back to the Future, Marty and Doc were always trying to get back to 1985. Whenever you complete a circuit, you know, an automotive circuit or any circuit for that matter, you run the positive power. It's always trying to return to ground, return to earth, return to 1985. We need to get Doc and Marty back to 1985. So what we want to do is we want to connect the negative or the ground to the vehicle to the 85 tab. So right there. Try not to touch those two. It'll create fireworks. Don't ask me how I know. I have the power from the battery ran to the 30 peg on the relay, and I have the ground to 1985 to get Doc and Marty back to the future. The next thing I need to do is hook up my switch. So what I'm going to do, we're going to pretend in the instance of my Rubicon where I want to tie this circuit to my high beams, this will be a wire coming from the high beam wire going to my headlight. I'm going to plug that into the 86 socket. And what that'll do is anytime this switch is turned on, there's going to be a click. It's going to turn on the circuit that's going to power this. So you can hear if you come close to it, get really close to this. And when I hit the power, you're going to hear it click. Hear that click? Mm-hmm. That means it's tripping the relay on that. So now we've got the power flowing through. So what we want to do is on the opposite side on 87, it's the highest thing. It's where we want the power to go. We want the power to go to the light. So your accessory or your light or hand warmers or whatever ties to the 87 peg on the relay. So now you've got power to it. The last thing to do is ground your light or your accessory. For this demonstration, I'm going to ground it right back to the battery. Most of the time you'll ground it somewhere to a wire somewhere on your ATV. But as soon as I touch this ground, the light comes on brightly, right in your face. And so now that light's on. And so what you'll do is this is going to represent the high beam on my Rubicon. So as soon as I flip that button forward, the relay kicks, the light turns on, and the light is getting powered directly from the battery, not getting it from my lighting circuit. So that's how a relay will work. A quick recap. The number 30 is your power. It's usually a 30 amp relay. You're providing 30 amps of power directly from the battery. 1985, Doc and Marty are trying to get back to 1985. That's the ground. Circuits always try to get back to the ground. The 85 is tied to your ground. The 86 and 87, the 86 will be your switch source. In this case, my ignition key. It's the switch source. So as soon as you flip a switch, the power hits. And the last component, the 87 is the power that goes to your accessory or your light bar. So that's how you wire a relay. And I'll be showing a video in the future on actually wiring it onto my Rubicon and show you exactly how it all works once it's done.